Hello, I'm Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm going to give you the concept of the four ages. And in India, these ages are well known. So in the West, the concept is not so clear. So that four ages, the concept of four ages called Yugs in Punjabi is not so well known in the West as it is in the East. Ages are based upon the religious qualities of majority of people, and the study of ages forms a good basis for undertaking religious studies. So if you want to know, then you should know what age you are in, what type of people you expect, and what the rabbis and Christ and other people stand for. Based upon the maximum three religious qualities: truth for children, the once born, hylics; contentment for the twice born, sensible people of the doubting type called Holy Father; and mercy for the twice born wise men sealed to serve God, led by Holy Ghost. Now, as I gave you in the Trinity, so they are all based upon Trinity. And I have given you the concept of this Trinity before, and here it is displayed. So you have this is a helix once born. Their religion is to speak the truth. Their duty towards God is truth. So truth comes from them. When you become twice born, doubting, you are here, whether to go for money or for God onward. For the doubting people, they are called Holy Father, and their religion is contentment. They are not to become greedy and become rich and become hypocrite, but their religion is contentment. And after you are contented, only then you can become merciful person. If you are a greedy person, you will be fleecing the poor, so there is no mercy in your heart. That rich Jew who came to Jesus, how could he be perfect? No, he became rich by fleecing the poor. So that's why Jesus said, give your money back to the poor and you are perfect, and join me. But he loved mammon. So these are the people who love mammon. And they are not contented with their lot. They want more and more. Whereas the Gentile were contented people. They were neither rich nor poor. So that's why the Samaritan displayed mercy. A rabbi passed by, a Pharisee passed by, because they loved mammon, no light. So a person of light came, the Samaritan man, he picked up the wounded person. He displayed mercy, and mercy is the light of our Father. So you know that mercy is the highest quality. So that's why the three qualities are truth, contentment, and mercy. And this people here, when you are sons of man, you are not fanatic. All right? When you are sons of man, you have tribal link with your elders. As people, Abraham, the Ishmael people had the tribal link with Abraham. When Christ Jesus was born, whereas the Jews, chosen people, had become Jews outwardly. They broke their covenant with Abraham, and they became unfaithful to Abraham. That's why baby Jesus was taken to Egypt under the protection of the sons of man. And when he grew up, he came back to Israel, the promised land, to do his duty for which he was sent. Then the rabbis and all that, they became his staunch enemies. So the gospel prospers among the sons of man, and they are called salt of the earth, and they are saltless bastards, worse than those born of the prostitutes. So these ages are also like this. In Satyug, all these four qualities are there, and that makes you perfect. So when you are perfect, then you are in the company of God, living in the Garden of Eden, and Adam and Eve, living in the Garden of Adam, sorry, Eden and, oh dear me, Garden of Edens. So when these qualities, you know, disappear, mercy disappear, then they are thrown out. They come here. This is the next one, you know. Sorry, this one is the next one. And after the mercy has gone, then contentment goes, then only truth is left. Then they are here. When the truth is left, gone also, then we have dark age, then we have people here, blind. The rabbis can make them fanatic, and those who are sensible, they become salt of the earth. John the Baptist came to make them salt of the earth. He was ideal rabbi. He was not crook rabbi. So ideal rabbi then turned them into salt of the earth, sons of Abraham, and handed them over to Christ Jesus. So John the Baptist only baptized the Jewish men who became Jews outwardly, while the Gentiles of Ishmael, they were always tribal. They did not become any religious form outwardly. They were religious inwardly. Their laws were written over their hearts and not in the book. And these people's laws were written in the book, scriptures. So with this general introduction, I hope the concept of four ages will become easy to understand. I may use this one again. So, let's see. So, based upon the maximum three religious qualities, truth for the children, the once born, hylic, contentment for the twice born, sensible people of the doubting type, holy fathers, and mercy for the twice born wise men, sealed to serve God, led by Holy Ghost. These three qualities are acquired through works. You have to, you know, through works called karma, by the efforts of an individual when he listens to his rabbi. And these qualities are also the measure of dharm. We call dharm in Punjabi, faith or iman in Arabic. The foundation of religion is shame. We call it SHARM, and in Arabic it is called HEEYA. And Hazrat Muhammad Sahib said, HEEYA is the 50% faith. He gave it so much importance to HEEYA, that is the salt of the earth. Measure of the salt of the earth displayed in conscience. If you don't have conscience, you have no salt of the earth. So altogether, we have four components. Three are qualities, and the fourth is conscience, which is a family salt, you know. So a person without conscience could not be a religious person. Typical example are the Jews occupying the properties and houses of the Palestinian. Such people are saltless people called tares, and they are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. So when you hear these stories, all these Jews go to a house, they find it unoccupied, they just break in and occupy it. And when the owner comes, Palestinian, they say, no, it's our property, it's our promised land. It is our right to occupy your property. And they are doing things which are worse than those which they suffered in the Holocaust. Based upon the above mentioned four, we have four religious ages or yugs in a cycle of ages. The eastern symbol of swastika represents this cycle of four ages. I understand that swastika is also displayed by many other countries. And because it's universal, you know, so you can expect it. Use of religious symbols in politics is wrong. What Hitler did, using it in the political affair, it is wrong, you know. The significance of these four ages is as follows. So in the next video, I will explain the significance of the four ages, starting with Golden Age for our Satyug. So we want to keep this video short so that you can have a good grasp of the subject. It's not difficult, it's very easy. As I explained, you have to go logical and you have to be thinking yourself, not depending upon the books. Books can't tell you. Books are dead letters. This subject is for the living in spirit, twice born people. God, our Father, blesses you.